So we're a few days away from Ostara, which is this Saturday coming, which is also my eldest daughter's birthday. March the 20th is Tilly's birthday. So it's really exciting. It certainly for me is a time that I think about fertility and actually becoming a mom, which I did on Ostara, which was amazing. And it's time to change the altar up. I have loved this altar, this Imolc altar. It's been well used. You can see all the incense has been burnt. This is my card that I pulled for this new moon cycle, which is the bear. That's from the Weaver's Oracle, which I'm loving. This little shelf down here is still really working. I've got things dumped on. I've got some of my dolls dumped on there. It needs a tidy up. Tilly painted me a squishy unicorn, and that's just given me a desire to get unicorns on the altar this time. Not necessarily Ostara, which is more hares and rabbits, but you know what? I'm just going with the energy I feel. So I'm going to try and stick to Ostara colours, pastels and yellows and pale colours, pretty colours. I'm going to think of magic, because for me, Ostara as a gardener, it's when seeds and shoots start to grow and you see the actual magic of a seed turning into a shoot coming through the earth. And for me, nothing sums up magic like unicorns. So I think I'm going to put some unicorns on this altar. And it's all inspired by Tilly's painted squishy unicorn. Oh, I'm going to keep the god and the goddess candle on as per normal. I'm going to keep my stones that represent me on. My Bridget picture needs to go back downstairs. Yeah, it just needs to tidy up. Right, let's get going. Oh, so I really want to show you this picture. Look at this picture. Oh my gosh, it makes me so happy. And look at that garden. If that doesn't remind me of spring coming in, I don't know what does. Now, this is a felt picture. It's one of those that you can colour in between the fuzzy felt. And I found it at the back of my daughter's wardrobe. It must have slid down the back of the wardrobe years ago. When I did her a room makeover for Christmas and made her bedroom a proper teenager's room, it must have been a forgotten Christmas present that just disappeared. So she didn't want it anymore. She's a teenager now and I really wanted it. It came with a little packet of three felt tip pens. Over Ostara, I'm going to take a week around Ostara. I can easily access it without disturbing the rest of the altar by sliding it in the back here. But I am going to colour this in. Oh my God, I'm so excited. It's ridiculous. Now, I've just been up in the loft and I found this beautiful silk flower, which has gone in my yellow pot. I'm finding some other flowers as well. Let me show you the bag of bits I found. So what have I found up in the loft? So I found bags of the kids' old toys. Look at that. So fertility for Ostara. Why don't we have a mommy unicorn and a baby unicorn? I found a bunny and some more flower crowns from when we did festivals. Another unicorn mommy. A whole load of unicorns and Easter baskets. Oh, broken unicorns that I bought broken for next to nothing from charity shops, but I am going to fix that today. The horns are missing. They were missing when I bought them. Let's put some magic flowers on instead. Look, there's a whole bag of goodies in there. So this is it so far. I love it. This makes me happy, which is what spring always, yeah, spring should make you happy. It feels hopeful, spring. So I've still got all my candles. Now these three candles are really important to me. I always like this one first. This is my goddess candle. This is my male energy god candle. This is a extra candle for my specific deities that I work with. So those three candles are really important to stay on. As is this dancing woman stone. Now this is a stone I found that looks like a woman dancing, I always think, and that's my self-love stone. This represents me. I've got different quartz on the altar as well. This is my healing after brokenness stone, my broken heart stone. So those are important on there. And then I've got flowers to represent spring. I've got my little unicorn and its mom to represent the magic and the fertility of spring and new life. I've got some bunnies. I've got some more bunnies downstairs as well, and I've got some amethyst in there. I've got Tinny's unicorn. I always like a nod to the fairies on here, and here I've got a fairy riding a unicorn. This is the unicorn that I got for literally pennies from a sale because it got broken and nobody wanted it, but I'm going to put feathers on the flowers on the end of there. So I have wrapped some little wire roses to match the flowers in the fairy's hair around the unicorn, and now I think that looks beautiful. I've also found, I haven't found them, they weren't lost, but I bought these two pots up from downstairs, and they are going to go on this bit of the altar. I'm using this sun ornament to place my weaver's card on, and I might keep it, but I need to go and clean this up now, it's filthy. And I've just realised that I've got my dark part of the umbrella over the top, which represents a turning wheel and the movement of the sun, but that's the darker one. I've got a yellow one somewhere and I can't find it. I can't remember where I put it. So I need to go in search of my other parasol to go up there. So I think I've finished. I've had such a lovely time doing this. So I've got my picture at the back ready to colour in. And lots of pinkness, Ostara colours. I fixed the unicorn here and gave him flowers to match the fairy on his back. I've got clear quartz and citrine and amethyst in here. There's a little heart in there for love and hope. And a bunny. And my goddess candle there underneath my swan and my crow. There is my god and my goddess candle, so male and female energy. And one of the unicorns up here with one little baby there. My cleansing bell. So that's the top of the altar. I still can't find the other parasol, but I quite like that purple with the pink anyway. And then if we come down to these shelves, this unicorn down here, I have added Tilly's squishy that she painted for me. So there's another two babies there and there with a mommy. I've got my sacred geometry cards there. I put one yellow sun there behind a unicorn, just tidied up my books. And if you come down onto this shelf, I put my large stones and stones that represent me. These go really well with this bear card. Also this crystal as well, I'm working with this card. I just like this sun as a holder for the weaver's card, it just works. I've got a yellow candle and an orange candle, so our star colours. A couple of unicorns at the back. So that's it guys, that's the Ostara altar. There's my bean bag that I meditate on. I've got some storage down there. On my other altar, which is here where all of my jewellery is hanging from, I have added a Morrigan inspired picture. I've got some Morrigan poetry under there. I've just given that a bit of a tidy up. I've got this crystal here, which I adore, which when I light these candles, it all shimmers, and sometimes I scry with that. So that's my goddess altar. I've done a bit of a tidy up. If I pan round, on this wall, some of the unicorns that I took off because it was looking too busy, I've made a little self-love, freedom sort of place. And I've put my new Frida deck. I've actually got two of these, which I love. One's downstairs on my art altar. A friend sent me this and I just love it. But look at these. Now, this donkey has got a story, which I'll go into another day, but he had a very sad start in life and I saved him. Now look, he's just a perfect card holder. So he's holding my Frida card. He's now a tarot card holder, which I think is just sublime. Look, this was a music box I bought Poppy. Isn't it beautiful? But it got dropped and it got broken. And she's kind of outgrown it now. She thought I would throw it away because it got broken. But no, I like the idea that one of the carousel horses broke out and became a unicorn. And this unicorn actually got broken as well. And I put a flower there. I don't like throwing broken things away. I think when you've felt broken yourself at times, I always like the thought of saving things. Does that sound odd? It probably does. And because it's Ostara, I got my hope picture out. Now this is one of my own artworks and I put that out there. So that wall, which is kind of all my artwork, is looking great. And I've put another one of my artworks here. And those are all my sewn artwork. I've got loads of picture frames and stuff stored down there. And if I pan round, back to my altar. So I've done a bit of a spring cleaning here, which again is part of the time of year. Just new starts. New beginnings, and I'm really pleased with it. I love the altar. I think it's fun, it's practical. I love it. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and happy Ostara.